Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cuban. In this video, we are going to look at how we can update a data source for a semantic model when leveraging deployment pipelines. But before we get into all of that, if you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. Let's talk about deployment pipelines. This came up from a customer scenario where they asked me, we're leveraging deployment pipelines, we're going from dev, test, prod, and when we go into those stages, what's the best practice for updating the data source? We don't want it to all just be the one data source, so. All right, let's see how this works. Enough all this talking, you know we like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. All right, I've got a deployment pipeline here. We've got AW dev, which has a report and a semantic model. And then we've also got AW prod, which also has the same. And right now these are in sync. The challenge here is if I go into my AW prod workspace and I go into the semantic model, go into settings, and we look and we actually see that it's pointed to the database that is my dev database. And I want this to point to my production database. So let's go back to the deployment pipeline. You actually have two options as part of that because one just wasn't good enough. So we need two. And these are done by way of deployment rules. And these rules take effect when the deployment actually happens. So we can configure these rules to actually update the data source. Let's go see how that works. Within my deployment pipeline, we'll see this little lightning bolt hover over that. It says deployment rules. Let's go ahead and click on that. And we'll see our semantic model here. So let's go ahead and look at the semantic model. And we've got two options here. We've got data source rules and we've got parameter rules. Parameter rules are grayed out because I don't have any Power Query parameters that are in the data set itself. If we go look at data source rules, we can see we don't have any rules set up. So let's go and add one. So we're going to change it from the dev database, and then we're going to choose other, and we'll change it to LT, which is our production database. And so if we go and hit save, bam. Now we can see that it's actually listed here as an option here for database and server, which is great. That's exactly what I want. So now if we do close and we close out of that, we'll see now that we're not in sync at this point. The thing to keep in mind is when we set up this deployment rule, it doesn't take effect until we do another push. You've got to go rerun the deployment so that it then applies that rule to your item. In my example, I just have dev and prod. So you could have any number of stages that you want. So it's dependent on the stage. You configure this per stage, except for the dev stage. So let's go ahead and hit deploy from dev, which will then deploy it to prod. And then we can see now that we have moved and it was successful. So let's go to AW prod now. If we go back to settings, we come in here and now we see that it shows AdventureWorks LT instead of AdventureWorks dev. So that's the first option, right? We can use this data source setting. It's limited by the type of data source that's there. So check out the documentation. I'll have links in the description below for the supported data sources and other limitations that apply. So this was specific to semantic models. Other items you may be using may have other rules associated with it. So, all right, let's look at the second option. The second option is using parameters, and this is an oldie but a goodie. But if we go look at the Power BI desktop file, if I go to transform data, you'll see here that I have set up two parameters inside of Power Query, one for the server name, one for the database name. And you can have this for whatever you want, right? This is just a good option to use if you're just changing out things within your Power Query syntax. So let's go see what this looks like inside of the service. So we go in, we can see our data set here for sales two. If we go to settings, now you'll see if I go to parameters, you'll see that I have the two parameters set up here. And this is pointing to my dev database. So as you would think, let's go back. And now we do our deploy first from dev to prod so that we can get our deployment rules to show up. So let's go ahead and do that. Now we've got both reports and data sets synced between the two workspaces. So let's go to our deployment rules. And now we'll see our sales to semantic model here. Let's go there. And now we see that this parameter rule is lit up. So if we look at that, we'll set up a new rule. So we'll choose our database rule to, we'll change it to LT instead of dev. And then we'll save that. Close, close. And if we go deploy one more time, because you need to deploy it again for the rule to take effect. So now when it copies the semantic model over, it's actually going to update that parameter value to point to LT instead of dev, which is great. So if we go look at the prod database, we go look at sales, come to settings, and we can see our parameter value now shows LT instead of dev. So why would you use one versus the other? As I mentioned before, for the actual data source settings, that has some limitations around which data source you can do this with. Whereas the parameter piece, it just works, right? So that might be a better option for you, especially if you're using a data source that's not supported in the data source settings. So that's something to think about. Also, you may have an item that you want to change that restricts maybe the number of rows or something like that. And that may be where you want a Power Query parameter that you update that when going to prod. So maybe in dev, you only look at the top 1,000 rows, but then when we go to prod, like give me everything, right? So that might be an option for you. All right, let me know down in the comments below, are you using deployment pipelines? Is this something that you've gone about? Did you learn something new? Let us know, I wanna hear. If you wanna see another great video from Guy in a Cube, video's gonna be floating above my head, so go check that out. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.